This video is brought to you by Squarespace. If you haven't heard of Squarespace, it is an amazing user-friendly platform that allows you to create and customize your own website, but also run email campaigns as well as certain other features which we are going to explain later during the video. Dear friends and rail lovers, for today we prepared another video from the series Rally Nation, in which we comprehensively discussed the rally systems of different countries. This time, the choice fell on Denmark. If you're wondering why, there are many reasons, but let's say that the most crucial one was the fact that this country is one of the best performing European railways. Namely, according to 2017 European Railway Performance Index, which includes the most comprehensive benchmarking of European railway systems, Denmark is ranked second. This list takes into account the three crucial components of railway performance: the intensity of use, quality of service and safety, and as you can see, Switzerland holds the first place. While in the top 5 besides Denmark, there are also Finland, Germany and Austria. As you could see on our channel from the list, we have already covered Switzerland, Germany, the Netherlands and Spain, and we will certainly do our best to cover all these countries in the future, and of course certain others from other continents. Now is maybe the right moment to kindly invite you to support us on Patreon, as well as to check out our online store where you can find some nice pieces of clothes and other stuff with railway motifs, whose sales will in turn support our production and give us the opportunity to improve the work of Railways Explained. These two are indeed crucial in enabling sustainable and better work of our channel. Links in the description. Now, as Norway has its fjords and mountains, Sweden has its forests and Finland has its thousands of lakes, what makes Denmark specific is the fact that it spreads across numerous islands. More precisely, there's an archipelago of about 440 islands, of which about 70 are inhabited. We have already mentioned this fact in the video in which we talked about the mega project Fehmarn Belt Fixed Link, which is being implemented between Germany and Denmark. The largest part of Denmark extends to the peninsula of Jutland, and the largest islands are Zealand, North Jutland, Funen and Lalland. The four cities with populations over 100,000 are the capital Copenhagen on Zealand, Aarhus and Aalborg in Jutland, and Odense on Funen. What is interesting about the Danish railways is that the construction of railway lines took place almost in parallel on the peninsula and on the islands, and that the first connection was made possible by large ferries. Before we continue, let's provide some additional context with the history part, where we will briefly explain the history of the Danish railways. According to official data, the first rail line in Denmark was the railway between Copenhagen and Roskilde on Zealand, which was opened for operation in 1847. The initial idea for the building was launched in 1840 by these two guys who published a paper in which they argued that a railway between Copenhagen and Roskilde might be profitable. It's important to mention that although this is considered to be the first railway in Denmark, in 1844 a 106 km long rail line was made, connecting Altona and Kiel on the territory of the Duchy of Holstein. The Duchy of Holstein at the time was in personal union with Denmark, with the King of Denmark being the Duke of Holstein. As a result of the Second War of Schleswig, Holstein was ceded to the German Confederation in 1864. In Jutland and Funen, the state decided on a somewhat different approach to building the railways. Here, the state financed and owned the rail infrastructure right from the beginning, whilst trusting the daily administration of lines to the private Danish Railway Operations Company. The railways in Funen and Jutland were built by Patton and Betts, who also supplied the locomotives. In 1862, the first line in Jutland was inaugurated, connecting the towns of Aarhus and Ranner. Other lines crossing Jutland, including the island of Funen, soon followed. When Patton and Betts went into insolvency in 1867, the Danish state nationalized the company and established the Danish State Railway in Jutland and Funen. On January 1, 1870, the Danish state railway network covered 494 kilometers. The first steam ferry connection between Fredericia and Strib, and thus under the auspices of the state railway, was established in March 1872. The Danish state took over the Railway Company of Zealand in 1880, forming the State Railways of Zealand. With majority of railways on both sides of the Great Belt owned by the Danish state, it was not until 1885 that the companies of Jutland, Funen and Zealand merged into one national railway company, the Danish State Railways, known also as DSB. However, the merger was not finalized before 1893. The 1930s were a decade of innovation and modernization for the DSB. New railway bridges have been built across the Little Belt in 1935, the Storstrom in 1937, and Ödeshund in 1938, eliminating the costly and time-consuming transfer by steam ferry. The first electrified railway in Denmark appeared quite late. The political decision to electrify the main lines was made in 1979. The first line to be electrified was Copenhagen-Helsingør in 1986 with 25 kV AC 50 Hz system, followed by the main lines across Zealand-Funen and Southern Jutland in the 1980s and 90s. Before we proceed with the story about the Danish rail reform, let's for a moment talk about our today's sponsor. Let's say that for whatever reason you need a website, but unfortunately you don't know web design. No problem. Squarespace is a platform that facilitates the creation and customization of a wide range of websites. It has many different and tastefully done templates that you can use to incredibly simple and fast create any kind of website. Also, among other, Squarespace can provide you with the necessary web domain. In addition, with the help of Squarespace, your website can get more reach using a very powerful email campaign reaching out to all your subscribers. Not enough reach? No problem. Squarespace allows very easy integration with your social networks, which helps you to additionally connect with your followers and your website to get even bigger popularity. If you want a free trial, which is no lose deal, we recommend you go to squarespace.com/railwaysexplained, where we have the opportunity to provide you with a 10% discount off your first purchase of a website or domain. Thank you, Squarespace, for supporting Railways Explained. Due to the adoption of the new directives at the EU level and the new approach to the organization of railways, as well as the internal state of the Danish railways, the restructuring has been carried out. Since January 1997, infrastructure management has been branched off into a new agency under the Danish Ministry of Transport, RailNet Denmark. It thus left the DSB with the task of train operation and management of the stations. DSB is responsible only for passenger operations on most of the Danish railway lines, bearing in mind that the Department for Freight Transport was merged with Rail Lion, now DB Cargo, in 2001. DSB also runs a commuter rail system called the S-Train in the area around Copenhagen, connecting the different areas and suburbs of the city. Also, after the announcement of the public tender for the public service obligation for passenger transport, Arriva won the tender for operating several regional services in Jutland, and now represents the biggest competitor to DSB. According to the IRG Rail Market Monitoring Report for 2019, there was a total of 14 railway undertakings in Denmark, 9 of which are for passenger and 5 for freight traffic. This already indicates that the market segment related to passengers is more dominant. This is certainly unique, having in mind that such situation in Europe is present only in the UK and Switzerland. We have to say that the years 2004 and 2005 were a nightmare for the RailNet Denmark. The company did not appear to have a sufficient overview of exactly how deteriorated the state railway network had become, due to decades of administrative and political neglect. This manifested in acute speed reductions across the country, especially during the summer periods and associated breakdowns in train traffic. Due to all the above, the Danish government changed direction and gradually set aside money with the aim of a complete settlement of the maintenance backlog and the establishment of quality infrastructure. From 2007 to 2013, RailNet Denmark experienced a political tailwind for the modernization and expansion of the railway lines and increased budget as well as the number of employees. Furthermore, RailNet Denmark received support to build Denmark's first 60 km long Copenhagen-Køge Rigsted high-speed line. The line was inaugurated in May 2019 and the operation started in June the same year. Construction took about 6.5 years, and this double-track line supports the speeds up to 250 km per hour. Its maximum capacity is 24 trains per hour. The current operating speed is 180 km per hour, bearing in mind that the existing trains are used, while the utilization of the full speed is planned from 2023, after equipping the trains with ETCS components. In addition, the maximum speed allowed on the other main lines is in general 180 km per hour, while on the other regional and local lines with less traffic, the trains usually move at between 75 and 120 km per hour. Before we move on to the truly exceptional figures about the transport performance, let's talk briefly about the game changer for Denmark. Against all odds and geography, the big bridges and tunnels completely managed to connect this disjointed country. Because of its geography, there was an absolute necessity for Denmark to build large engineering structures with large transport capacity to ensure the integration of the Danish transport system. It was also needed to ensure the connection of Scandinavia with continental Europe. Therefore, Denmark is currently home to two major infrastructure projects that are financed by user charges: the Great Belt fixed link between the islands of Zealand and Funen, and the Øresund fixed link between Denmark and Sweden. We also have the fixed link across the Fehmarn Belt, about which we talked in detail in a special video. The Great Belt fixed link is a multi-element fixed link crossing the Great Belt Strait. It consists of, so to say, two sections. First, a road suspension bridge and a railway tunnel between Zealand and the small island of Spoy in the middle of the Great Belt. The second is the box girder bridge for both road and rail traffic between Spoy and Funen. The total length is 18 km. The construction began in 1991 and was completed in 1998. The construction cost for the entire project totaled to approximately 4.8 billion euros in 2010 prices. By train, the time savings were significant. The journey has been reduced by 60 minutes, and there are many more seats available because more carriages may be added to a train that now does not have to fit on a ferry. The seating capacity offered by DSB across the Great Belt on an ordinary day has risen from 11,060 seats to 37,490 seats. Although technically more Swedish than Danish, since the longest stretch crosses Swedish waters, the iconic Øresundsbron links Denmark with Sweden. Even its official name is a merger of the two neighbors, combining the Danish Ø and the Swedish word for bridge. The Øresund Bridge is a combined railway and motorway bridge across the Øresund Strait between Denmark and Sweden. It is located nearly 8 km from the Swedish coast to the artificial island of Piberholm in the middle of the strait. The crossing is completed by the 4 km Drogden tunnel from Piberholm to the Danish island of Amager. Construction began in 1995 and was completed in 1999. The traffic was released in July 2000. The construction costs of the entire project totaled to approximately 3 billion euros in 2010 prices. The railway is an important part of the Øresund Bridge. Around 2/3 of those traveling across the Øresund Bridge go by train, with a journey between Malmö and Copenhagen taking 35 minutes. As we have already pointed out, the railway network in Denmark is divided into one managed by Banedanmark and one operated by private infrastructure managers. The total length of the rail lines in Denmark is 2,485 km, of which about 80% is managed by Banedanmark. You can see the lengths on the graph, in which we did not include the light rail and the Copenhagen Metro. Of 1,998 km managed by Banedanmark, 1,015 km is multi-tracked, while 776 km is electrified. When we talk about private managers, their rail lines are not electrified. Denmark is the first country in Europe that has decided to replace all analog signaling systems with a digital IT system using ERTMS. A complete upgrade of the rail signaling systems is one of the most ambitious infrastructure projects in Europe, with an investment of more than 3.3 billion euros over a period of 12 to 11 years. This decision was facilitated by the Danish Parliament in January 2009, which obviously planned to totally replace the legacy, life-expired and obsolete signaling systems deployed on Danish soil. Some of them date back to the 1930s, and for them became progressively more difficult and expensive to find and acquire spare parts, as well as to support and maintain Danish train control. It's good to know that network signaling problems accounted for more than 50% of train delays. Six lines totaling more than 350 km are already equipped with ERTMS. The total number of trains yet to be retrofitted with onboard devices is around 300, of which more than half have already been put into service with ERTMS Level 2. All existing trains will be equipped by Alstom, but new trains are being supplied with the ERTMS system of the operator's or manufacturer's choice. What is certainly fascinating is the transport performance in the passenger transport segment. Although Denmark has about 5.8 million people, in 2019, the year before the pandemic, it carried over 200 million passengers, or over 500,000 passengers every day. On the screen, you can see the evolution of the passenger transport performance in the last 5 years, including the performance on private rail networks. Most of these passengers are transported by DSB as train service. Also, the number of passengers traveling between Sweden and Denmark via the Øresund Bridge is not negligible. In order to achieve this performance, it is necessary to organize a robust and efficient timetable, whose overall process of development we have already covered in the timetable video. Well, the Danish timetable makes over 3,000 trains run on the rail network every day, or over 1 million trains a year. On the screen, you can see the total number of trains in 24 hours and at peak hours on most tracks in Denmark. And all of this, amazingly, with a high level of train punctuality. No wonder they are ranked second according to 2017 European Railway Performance Index. Speaking of trains, Alstom has won the largest train tender in Danish rail history. The first part of a framework agreement with DSB, valued at a total of 2.6 billion euros, is the order of 100 Coradia Stream regional trains and a 15-year full-service maintenance agreement, which amounts to 1.4 billion euros. The framework agreement includes an additional 15 years of maintenance and the possibility to order additional train sets. Delivery of DSB's Trains of the Future is scheduled to begin in the last quarter of 2024. As for freight transport, it is realized on the lines operated by Bane Denmark, at least according to statistics we found. In 2020, about 8.6 million tons of goods were transported and almost 70% was transit traffic. As we have encountered limited amount of documents available in English language while researching this topic, we invite our viewers from Denmark and other parts of the world who are familiar with the situation to tell us in the comment section their opinion or first-hand experience with this great railway system. You were watching the story of the Danish railway system on Railways Explained. Before the end, we would like to thank all our patrons for their generous support. If you want to support Railways Explained too, you can do it directly on Patreon or you can buy some cool railway stuff in our online store. Links in the description. This was all for today. We hope you enjoyed and learned something new about the railways of the world. Don't forget to like this video, share it with your rail-loving friends, and of course, subscribe to our channel. Until the next time, goodbye.